Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we'll show what to do when you have two meshes with the same topology, but for some reason, a different vertex order. I'll show you how to solve this problem in wrap using only the Match Topology tool. We'll go through a practical example, so let's get started. For example, I prepared these two meshes. I'll drag and drop both files into the graph panel and press Create Multiple Nodes. Now in wrap, we have two heads. We can take a look from the front and compare them. As you can see, they have the same topology. Let's try to mix them with a mixed geo node. I connect two heads. Now when I move the blend slider, you can see the geometry explode. The issue appears because their vertex order is different even though the topology is the same. This can happen when a model passes through different software, some tools change the vertex order, and now we have to fix it. This problem can be solved very easily with the Match Topology node. Here, I'll connect the mesh we need to fix, our head. In the second input, I'll connect a reference mesh with the correct vertex order. Now we have the same mesh, but with a new vertex order. Let's plug the result into the first input of the mixgeom node. I'll move the blend slider, and as you can see, the geometry now behaves correctly. This happens because the vertex order is correct. You can see the before and after. Let's take a look at some additional settings. I'll click the Match Topology node and open the Visual Editor. Here, we can see both heads side by side. In most cases, the tool works fully automatically, but for some meshes, it may fail to find the proper vertex order if the mesh is symmetrical or the biggest. In this case, you can provide manual vertex correspondences to help the algorithm find the correct vertex order. But again, you won't need this in most cases. Now let's look at an example that often happens in practice. I'll open a new project. I have prepared the geometry for this example. We can drag and drop the files into the graph panel. We have a hand scan and a hand mesh. I'll turn off the wireframe. Here's how it looks. Let's try to wrap this base mesh onto the hand scan while preserving as much detail as possible. Here the topology is good, but it's too high poly, which makes it hard to wrap and clean up. So I'll use the unsubdivide geom node. Let's set the level to 2 to get a low poly mesh. Now we have a lower density topology. Let's use the fast wrapping node to conform one mesh onto another. I'll connect the unsubdivided hand to the first input and the scan hand to the second. For fast wrapping to work correctly, I'll provide explicit correspondences so the tool understands which part aligns to which. I'll use the select point pairs node. Let's connect the mesh hand to the first input and the scan hand to the second. In the visual editor, I'll place paired points on the pinkies, ring fingers. Let's also select points on the middle fingers. Okay. This anchors the key areas and is enough for a clean result in my case. I'll connect this node to the third input. Let's press compute. Our hand now has the shape we need. We can compare the result with our scan. Let's increase the mesh density to capture more detail from the scan. I'll add a subdivide geom node. Let's set the subdivision level to 2 to get a denser mesh. Then I'll add fast wrapping node again to capture more detail. The wrapped hand goes to the first input, the scan hand to the second. I'll press compute. This process may take a bit longer. Good. If we turn off the wireframe, you can see the mesh has much more detail. Let's compare the before and after. Now we've restored the original mesh density, but there's a catch. When we unsubdivided and then subdivided, the vertex numbering changed. So we can add a mixed geom node and try to blend our final result with the original mesh. You'll see they're no longer blendable, even though the polygon count matches. This happens because a mesh from other softwares may use a different subdivision algorithm that produces a different vertex order. When we unsubdivide and then subdivide in wrap, we're using wrap's algorithm. So the new vertex order no longer matches the original from other 3D programs. But we can solve this problem. let's add a match topology node before mixgeom. I'll connect our final mesh to the first input and use the original mesh as a reference. Then reconnect mixgeom. Now it works correctly. The meshes share the same vertex order. That's all for this tutorial. We covered mesh subdivisions and fixing vertex order mismatches with the match topology node, and we went through a practical example to see where this issue can show up. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.